published 1511 est, the 16th of November 2017, updated 1724 est, the 16th of November 2017. David Davis today urged Germany not to put politics above prosperity in the Brexit talks as he laid out his vision for close trade links after we leave. The Brexit Secretary said he is under no illusions that the negotiations are tough but said real progress has been made. And he said Britain wants to continue to work closely with the bloc on trade and security after the UK leaves in March 2019. Addressing German business leaders in Berlin tonight, he warned it is never a smart choice to put politics above the wealth and prosperity of your country. And he said the two countries do a lot of lucrative trade with each other, with 1 in 3 of every car sold in the UK made in Germany, and this must not be thrown away in Brexit talks. His bid to woo German business comes as the government prepares to pull out all the stops to try to convince EU leaders to move on to trade talks by the new year. David Davis, pictured in Downing Street this week, has told an audience of business leaders in Germany that Britain wants close links with the EU after we quit the bloc. Speaking in Berlin tonight, Mr. Davis said trade creates jobs, it boosts prosperity. And it creates wealth not just in Britain, not just in Germany, but right across Europe. In the face of those facts, I know that no one would allow short-term interests to risk those hard-earned gains. Because putting politics above prosperity is never a smart choice. A leak from Europe today suggested the bloc is getting ready to rule out Britain's call for a bespoke trade deal when we quit the bloc. Instead, they want a looser Canada-style arrangement that would not cover much of Britain's crucial services industry. Negotiating briefs seen by Politico suggest such an agreement would only mean limited EU commitments to allow cross-border provision of services, but Mr. Davis today again urged the continent to recognize Britain's unique starting point in the talks and come up with a closer trade deal. He said we will be a third country partner like no other. Much closer than Canada, much bigger than Norway, and uniquely integrated on everything from energy networks to services. Theresa May is said to be ready to offer another £20 billion to kickstart Brexit talks with the EU amid fears Brussels is determined to hammer the City of London. The Prime Minister could brave the fury of Tory Eurosceptics by pledging more cash in a bid to break the deadlock over starting trade discussions. But she is expected to ignore a deadline set by the EU's chief negotiator that she must spell out the divorce bill offer by the end of next week in order to make progress before Christmas. The task facing Mrs. May was underlined today when it emerged that Brussels is resisting calls for a bespoke deal with the UK. The key pillar of this will be a deep and comprehensive free trade agreement, the scope of which should be beyond any the EU has agreed before. He urged for a deal that covers goods, agriculture, and services, including financial services, and he clarified that during a two-year transition deal UK and European markets would continue on current terms. On security, he said Britain wants to stay the closest of partners with the EU, pointing out that innocent people on the streets of Germany, France, Britain and all over Europe all face the same deadly terror threat. He said that is why we have already set out our ambition for continued partnership in areas such as security, defense, law enforcement and counter-terrorism, drawing on the weight of our military, intelligence, diplomatic, law enforcement and development resources to lead action both inside and outside Europe, hand in hand with our closest allies and partners. Our determination to defend the stability, security and prosperity of the European continent remains steadfast. Because the threats European people face are the same, whether they are attending a pop concert in Manchester, Christmas markets in Berlin or simply using public transport in Brussels, Madrid or London. Prime Minister Theresa May today held talks with Swedish Prime Minister Stefan Löfven during a bilateral meeting prior to an EU summit in Göteborg. She is pushing for EU leaders to agree to move on to trade talks before the new year. Theresa May, pictured speaking with Swedish Prime Minister Stefan Löfven today, is set to offer the EU another £20 billion, the divorce bill, to kickstart trade talks. Britain always has, and always will, stand with its friends and allies in defense of the values we share. Meanwhile, Theresa May traveled to Gothenburg to hold talks with Swedish Prime Minister Stefan Löfven as she tries to convince EU leaders to move on to trade talks. Commenting on the discussions, a number 10 spokesman said on Brexit, the two leaders discussed the progress made so far in the negotiations on citizens' rights, Northern Ireland and the financial settlement. PM May reiterated her wish for the UK to have the smoothest possible exit from the EU followed by a deep and special partnership. Both leaders said they wanted to see further positive discussions ahead of the December European Council. PM Löfven said that, post-Brexit, he wanted strong Swedish relations as well as a strong relationship between Britain and the EU.